cannot wait. I'm so excited. So, Pastor, do you want to say anything?
I just feel two things. Number one, God is taking us to another level. And I feel like tonight, God's healing people. I don't know what it is, but if you need healing, you are going to get healed tonight. It's the beginning of a healing revival.
Amen. 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 Y'all get ready, because the Holy Ghost is here. The presence of God is in this room. And His presence is for the hungry. Amen. I don't want to waste it on anything that's not. You know, when I cook a good meal, and you know, I don't want it to be wasted. I want us to enjoy it. So He's given us a good meal tonight, and He wanted the ones that are here tonight are the ones that's come to receive and get to feast on this good meal. And Pastor gonna take this mic from me.
Let me say this. On the day of Pentecost, Jesus asked 500 to come, but only 120 stayed.
Wow.
He asked 500, but only 120 stayed. Yeah. And waited on the Holy Spirit. Boom.
And let me just say this, because I love to talk about the elephant in the room. I am not, let me tell you, I am not worried or concerned, and I'm saying this to you, worship ministry. I don't care if we're not singing to anybody out here, okay? Because the Holy Ghost is here, and He's going to be glorified. He's going to be lifted up, and He, when we lift Him up, He will stop people on the highways and cause them to turn in and come into this place for the ones that are needing His touch, okay? So, I'm not worried about numbers. I quit that a long time ago. I'm here for Him. So, y'all, give it up for the number one in our audience tonight. Hallelujah. Audience of one. In Jesus' name we worship you, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
Lamb of God, I am. Sweet.
the Lion of Judah is roaring with power. You keep fighting our battle, and every knee will bow before my God. Our God is the Lamb, oh yeah, the worthy Lamb of God. For the sins of the world, your blood breaks every chain. Every knee will bow before the open up the gates in Tuscaloosa, Lord. Yeah, you open up the gates, make way before the kingdom. The God who comes to save is here to set the captives free. Who can stop the Lord? Oh, who can stop the Lord? No one can stop the Lord. No one can stop the Lord. I said, no one can stop the Lord. No one, no one. No one can stop the Lord. No one can stop the Lord. Well, no one can stop the Lord. King Jesus. No one can stop the Lord. No one can stop the Lord. Stop the Lord, King Jesus. No one can stop the Lord. No one can stop the Lord. No one can. Our God, yeah.
Our God is the Lion, the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battle.
house fires, Atlanta. And I will build my life upon your awesome love. It is my firm foundation, and I will put my trust in you alone. And I thank God I will not be shaken, that I'm in, and I will build my the name above, so very high above every other. the boat and go to the other side. And he went halfway up the mountain. He was praying. This is what I love about my Jesus. Wow. He came down from prayer. He came to the Sea of Galilee, the lake, which I've been on three different times in Israel. And he just kept walking. That's who he is. I'm talking about my Savior. He just, water? Okay, I just. And then the disciples, all full of fear, said, okay, it's a ghost. And Peter goes, no, look, it's the Lord. And Peter, I don't know what he was thinking, but he said, Lord, bid me come. Peter, what? What? What did he say? He got out of the boat. I'm pretty sure he hadn't said, peace be still yet. So he, and that's a shallow lake, and those waves are pretty intense. They curl off real fast in the Sea of Galilee. He started sinking. He cried, Lord, I know. But Peter, at least we're giving you props, bro. You got out of the boat, walking on the water. Here's the point. The people of God, we will never be stuck in a storm. We're not going to fear in the storm because he said, I will not be shaken. But if you trust in him, if you think COVID was tough, if something harder comes, people said, I'm going to run for the hills. And I said, what are you going to find there? Nothing. You're going to run for the hills and do what? Even all the survivalists, I got news, they're coming for your food. I believe in manna in the backyard and pheasants in the front yard. Or maybe it was inverted. Manna in the front yard and pheasants. How many love those stories? How many believe in miracles and the supernatural stuff of the Lord? And here we go tonight. So we go to that song, and we'll be offering prayer tonight. The key of F, boys and girls. I believe in you. I believe in you. You're the God of miracles. I believe in you. I believe in you. Yeah. You're the God of miracles. Sing it out. And I believe in you. the God of the impossible. It's who you are, the God of the impossible. Oh, don't you love it? Yeah. God of the impossible. It's who you are. Come on, let's sing a little spontaneous song. Oh, God of the impossible. It's who you are, God of the impossible, sweet Jesus. It's who you are, yeah, God of the impossible. Crossing over. I always go before the Lord. I slow my schedule down. I was doing, up till COVID, 3 worship weekends a month, so 34 to 36 a year. I own my life. It's so good, and I love the anointing. Don't you love singing and playing under the anointing? It's heavenly, man. There's nothing. You can throw tomatoes at me and cuss at me. You can't touch me when I'm leading worship. That's what I'm talking about right there. That was really good. Could people give me bad? You know, did you ever notice, Julian, people have a rough week? They don't sit in the same, they sit in the back and they scowl at you. I say, you can't touch me with that, man. Get right. Or stay home and get your beauty sleep, whatever you want to do. That was good right there. It really was. We want to be nice, but, and stop coming in late. Our worship team actually rehearsed and we were ready for you guys and they keep coming in late. Why? That's pretty rude, don't you think, Julian? I'm just saying what you were thinking a couple times. So. It's all right. It's going to be okay later. But tonight we're going to put a drop of oil. We're praying for everybody in this house because he said crossing over. So listen really close, 3 parts. He said, you tell my people, Kent, I'm giving them a warning. It's pretty heavy. He said, they got to pull up their tent stakes and roll up their little tent, put it on their cart and come with me into new lands. Some people camped out. They said, we're not moving. COVID was tough. We had fear on us. I got you. But he said, you got to pull up your tent stakes. You got to go. The Lord's invitation said, come cross over into new lands with me. Thanks for being clear, Kent. I know. I'm going to say it again. He said, why don't tell my people they need to come with me at my invitation and cross over into new lands for 2021 and 2022. Hey, thanks for giving us 24 months, Lord. I mean, this is a definitive. People say, I need a prophetic word. I'm giving you one right now. That was the first part. The second part is you say, tell my people they're going to the next realm of higher levels of my anointing and presence. And I love that personally because I'm a small man. I've been married 45 years. I've been in ministry 45 years. But I was thinking, I know probably a thimble full in sowing, a thimble. People go, Kent, you're massive, bro. You know, you got, you know, all these years you taught. I said, compared, I want to go to Gabriel's School of Worship or David's School of Worship when I cross over. David, we could go. We could go together. Could just think if there's a school of worship, Julian, over there. We could get over there. I know. So I'm signing up. And they said, all right, bro. Some people said, well, Kent, we already saw you leading worship in heaven. I said, we'll see. I do love the Lamb, but, bro, that's a heavyweight statement. Just wait a minute. Wait a minute. But just think, he said, I'm going into higher levels with everybody else of his anointing and presence. We probably know a thimbleful. Did you get what I said? That was number two. And number three, he said, tell them to press into me because I'm going to show them realms of heaven they've never seen before. The book of Revelation, you are peering into heaven, if, in case you didn't know that. It's, thank God. I was thinking, Scott, the denomination, and I love all these people. The Church of Christ had three different splits because they couldn't have instruments in their church. I went, what? I said, well, no, we're doing acapulco singing. That's what I call it, acapella. We changed it at Webster. We said it's acapulco singing. No music, just the voices. And I get that. I would do that occasionally, but not all the time. Well, we can't find instruments in the New Testament. I go, what? What? What'd you say? The Old Testament believers, the hora, the dance they do, and the instruments are in heaven. So could you not find the carry through into the... Anyway, religious people fight over everything, right? Rules and regulations. Jesus went for that. He didn't like the Pharisees. He said, Lord, thank you, because they get on my nerves. The Pharisees get on my nerves. He said, the Pharisees, can't you hear the children are crying, Hosanna? What are you going to do about that, Jesus? And he quoted Psalm 8. And have you not heard that out of the mouths of nursing babies and children, I perfected praise? And did you ever hear it? You probably haven't. But a baby, Ariel, my youngest daughter, just had her first baby. And this baby, she can cry, bro, because she cries perfectly from her diaphragm. Every vocal teacher will say, the problem with most singers, they're not using their diaphragm as a vocal major. You know, I studied all that. Babies cry perfectly because they use their diaphragm. How many have been around a crying baby and go, oh my God, please stop? But they're hungry or their diaper needs to be changed. But think about this. He said back to the Pharisees, isn't this cool, Nathan? He said, have you not read where out of the mouths of nursing babies and children, praise is perfected? And then further, this is bonus. He said, it'll drive away the avenger, the one that was coming to dole out justice. So tonight we're gonna pray this word. I want everybody to come on out of your chairs, come to the front single file line, get the oil out. Scott and Christy, we're laying hands on people. This is a night of blessing. We may not get to this tomorrow morning. How many people, this is your home church? Maybe I should do, how many people this, let's do the, how many people this is not your home church? We got half and half here tonight, something like that. But come on out. This is the time of blessing in the Lord. The time of blessing. This is unusual. I want the worship team, the singers, put down your microphones and go down and get prayer, because you won't do it. We won't do that tomorrow for sure. I want the singers to receive the blessing of the Lord. Somebody said amen. Thanks for sharing, Kent. Absolutely. And I brought another special song for Scott, my buddy, my friendly worship leading friend. I worship you, Almighty God. Help me remember. Out of the 70s and 80s, the scriptures. Most of these kids down here were born after the 90s or 2000. But tonight we're praying just so. And, you know, David, if you and Cindy want to come out again and pray, there's quite a few people. And we're just doing the cross, the time of blessing, the release. We're going to the strength and power of the Lord. How many, let me, by show of hands, let me, if you could use a blessing tonight from the Lord, let me see your hands. I'm all in. Yes, ma'am. You and me. We're getting a blessing from the Lord. Miss Sparky, cheery heart. Don't let the devil get you down anymore. It's a good day for Jesus, girl. Wow. Christy, go touch her. Start. Oh, it's the night of your blessing. And she's weeping. Somebody right there, somebody, oh, Christy. This is what we came for right here. This is what your primary worship pastor, worship leader Julian told me. He said it twice. He picked me up last night and today. We're preparing our church for the broken. There's so many broken people that need to be healed. So you're getting blessed tonight that you could lay hands on others and get it done. Little Missy Doodle right here. You can lay hands on people and they'll receive a blessing, right? Yeah, whether you're used to it or you've never done it before, I don't care. It's going to happen. God's going to use you guys here in this line tonight. Wow, so the release of the Lord is here. You can feel it. We're going to worship our way through this segment. Because we own the joint. This is Daystar Church. We don't have to run out of here at 6:30 or 7:30. This is a worshiping church right here at Daystar. I worship you, oh mighty God. And there is none like David. You and Cindy start praying for others, yeah. And I worship you. Awesome. Oh, Prince of Peace. That is what I want to do. And I give you praise. For you are my time of your blessing came on Saturday night in April. Yeah, and I worship you, Almighty God. And there is none like you. Oh my God, this is awesome. Crossing over tonight, the Lord's releasing the word. And I give. blessing reign of the Lord. There is none. Oh my God. And I worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what I want to do. I give you praise, for you are my righteousness. How beautiful is this? All the worship team singers, come on over. Right here. That's right, BJ. Fill in the space, singers. Lord of Lords, are you Jesus? Yeah. King of Kings. Reign of the Lord. Father, we begin to release over this worship team of Daystar, even the ones playing with the singers tonight, they're crossing over, Lord, higher levels of the anointing, higher levels of your presence. Lord, we're rolling up our tent, we're putting on our little cart, we're following into you into new lands, crossing over. We're following you into new lands, crossing over. By the laying on of hands tonight, this is the impartation of your blessing. The impartation of your blessing rain. The impartation. The impartation. My God. The song is Lean Back. It's a new song. We're releasing at Daystar this weekend. Lean back in the shalom of the Lord. And when I heard this, see, I choose my songs based on ministry value, not on what is on Joy FM or Kayla. I mean, I pick the stuff that people have asked me for years, Dave. I said, listen, I'm picking my songs. I can minister and sing right out of them and use the chord progression, hang out in the presence and linger with yearning, huh? And I heard this, you will never, can we put the words up to this, Shannon? Your love sustaining me, thank God. Before I even knew what love was, love brought me to Jesus. Somebody love me. You brought me here to rest. And you brought me here to rest. You've given me space to breathe. So I'll stay still until it sinks in. Your love sustaining me. Before I even knew what love was. Oh, this is so sweet, so full of the shalom of God. And I will lean back in the loving arms of a beautiful Father. Oh. Show the violin player. Breathe deep and know that you are, oh, we're getting it now. You're a love like no other. I will lean back, my God, and I will lean back in the loving arms of a beautiful Father. Oh, yeah, turn his mic up a little bit, violin, bro. And I will breathe deep and know that you are so good. You're a love like no. That's beautiful, singers. Yeah, again, you will never leave out. You will never leave. Yeah, your love sustaining. Thank God. Let's go, David, with the singers. Yeah. You brought me here, and you brought me here to rest. I'm resting, God.